Hey everyone, this is the beginning of potentially a show which is not yet named, but I am really excited about starting something, and I have been reading influential, awesome people who say that you should just start. So this is the beginning, hopefully, of something awesome. My goal with this is to provide you value. My passion is learning. I love to learn practical things about life, and the only thing I love as much as learning is teaching other people what I have learned. So, for those of you who do not know me, I'm going to get used to talking to the camera. It's so exciting. Hey, for those of you who do not know me, I am Alicia Eichmann. I'm from Kansas City, Missouri, born and raised there, went to college in Oklahoma, moved to Virginia to get my master's in literature, biblical literature, basically a research and writing degree. Really learned a ton about research and learning and how to learn and how to write, just the whole research process, and met some amazing people. Higher education is fun. It's special. We'll get into that. Anyways, I currently reside in Suffolk, Virginia. I'm still here in Hampton Roads, and I have 4 boys, age almost 8, 6, 3, and 1. And they are super fun. They are a handful. I have been debating what to share with you all first from my journey, and I've decided to start with books. So, my current journey really began in some ways about 5 years ago. I was working part-time as kind of a webmaster, sort of project manager. I was really an all-purpose admin. We had a really small staff. Well, it was really just me at first. So I did the web, and I did the website and some admin stuff. And I had a 2-year-old and a baby because they're 21 months apart. So I had a 24-month-old and a 3-month-old. And I started to wonder if I really could work and stay home with the kids. And I was already blessed with a job where I was able to do it mostly from home, go and, you know, get a babysitter, go in for some meetings. And I was just really questioning if I could do both, if I should keep doing that. I felt like I needed to work because of student loans. I also really enjoyed the intellectual outlet. I wanted to stay up on trends and continue to learn. I'd started learning HTML and CSS and a lot of coding. Now it's HTML5. But I know a lot about websites and coding and project management. And I'm so grateful for their first book that I want to profile. I discovered Laura Vanderkam. I will try to normally share how I discovered authors. I unfortunately do not remember how I discovered her because it was 5 years ago. I want to say I love Amazon. I want to say I've been on Amazon since you only bought books, because I've always loved books. So, and I love that in Amazon, in my order history, I have a book of I have a record of every book I've ever ordered, which comes in very handy when I got to the point where I wanted to start documenting this and making a list and revisiting. And I've started to really rethink and look back at books that have influenced me. With an aim to sharing that with you. So this book, I think I actually did look up time management in Amazon, something like that. Anyways, I found Laura Vanderkam, 168 hours, and she simply spells out the math and explains that if you work 40, which I work 30 hours a week, and then you get 8 hours of sleep at night, which I do, I like sleep. My husband laughs at me, but I love it. I need my 8 hours. That's 56. And so that's 96. And so that's still 72 hours left in your week, which is 10 hours a day. Now, as moms, we all know. I want to speak more to just moms. If you're not a mom, that's okay. And I have fun insights for you that will be coming about looking ahead to motherhood and thinking about marriage or thinking about children. But for everybody else who is a mom, you know that that time gets eaten up, and there really are seasons where you have more or less time, especially between nursing, potty training, just different things, cooking, cleaning. that time can really get whittled away. However, I did the time journal exercise that she talks about in the book, and it was very enlightening. When you do that kind of exercise, you really see how much time you do spend on downtime, decompressing, relaxing, chilling, whatever you call it, that thing that keeps you sane. And we all make time for that in our lives because we need it. And it's an interesting exercise to start to pay attention to what that is and to read her book and to think about what that could be. Anyways, current point that I'm making right now, she was very influential in helping me to decide that I could continue to work part-time and raise my kids too, that I could do both. She helped me to adopt the belief fundamentally that I had enough time and energy for both. Now, it helped that I love my job. I love what I do. Part of my job involves constantly learning things. I've gotten good at learning new things. That's been part of my job. New technology, new app, new software, new program, new idea, new project, whatever we're doing, explore it, figure it out. What does it look like? How can we use this? How can we integrate it to what we're doing? That's a large part of what I do. I love that. And so, fortunately, there's a certain intellectual outlet that my work has been able to, you know, to kill two birds with one stone, right? So if you are thinking about how to organize your life, and you hear the term a lot, work-life balance, if you're thinking about how to fill your time and what you have time for, I highly recommend this book. I've really enjoyed it. She's done some fun mini ebook follow-ups, but this is still her like main work on this topic. I also really liked her book about money. Really, really enjoyed that. I recommend that too. But this was influential to me. I would not be where I am today if I had not decided that I could do both. And there's definitely sacrifices that I made, but I really did need to work some anyways. So I have really been able to learn a ton about marketing. I love marketing, advertising. More and more I've gotten out of the web, which I've benefited from continuing to understand that. But as my company's hired more people, I've gotten into web marketing and advertising and project management, helping people work together. And just recently really getting into social media. So I am very excited to welcome you to this journey. We are going to talk about books and then also potentially websites and apps that I have learned. And I want to tell you why I'm sharing them with you, what I learned from them, what I think you could benefit. And my goal is going to be to summarize books for you that you may or may not have a chance to read, to introduce apps to you or websites, web programs that you may have not heard of or explored, and help you to know if that's worth exploring, to see that you could get into whatever that app is, whatever that idea, if you don't know that it exists, and if it's a book, to help you know if it's worth taking your precious time to read it. So here we go. That was my first one. I have to say that I have been reading and following Gary Vaynerchuk, who I just discovered, and he is talking right now a lot about documenting instead of creating, especially, well, for me, I feel like he said lots of things about it, but something I got from that was especially to get over the hump of creating. I got into my blog last year. I loved it. I couldn't figure out the work-life balance, and was taking too much away from my family. I was trying to figure out what to do. Still needed to put plenty of time into my job. Learned some new skills that were, you know, relevant to the job, but I paused it and now I'm coming back. I'm thinking about video blogging, and I still want to come back around to writing, but I think I've got to potty train my 3-year-old and my 1-year-old needs to start sleeping more and playing more on his own, which if you've got children, you know that your life really does ebb and flow with the life stages of your children. So until next time.